whatsoever. Now the enemies came marching. Hallelujah, they came marching with a purpose. We're coming to come. We're coming to hallelujah, apprehend David. We are coming to subdue him. We are coming to arrest him. We got an arrest warrant from the king. And when they got to Naioth, all they did was step into the presence of God and got laid out. Somebody give God praise in his house. Hallelujah. Now Saul is waiting for them to come back. They don't come back. They don't send word. Saul sends a second commission of soldiers. They go and they march the same purpose, the same plans. Notice the devil has the same purpose and the same plans for years. He's been trying to kill you. He's been trying to stop you. He's been trying to eradicate you. He's been trying to get you out of the playing field. But it doesn't matter the plans of the enemy. What matters is the presence of God. Can I get a witness in this house? So now they come again. They are marching. Hallelujah, purpose in mind. We are about to arrest him later. We are going to come and bring him back to Saul. They step into the atmosphere of presence of God and all of a sudden get laid out as well. Hallelujah, Saul is waiting and doesn't hear back. He sends a third commission. They walk and they walk and they walk. They come in and the same thing happens. It doesn't matter what you're going through. When the presence of God is protecting you, all the devil might try, but it will not happen. He can try, but it will not come to pass. What happens now? Hallelujah. King Saul says, oh, they haven't come back. I sent three commissions of soldiers, and they did not return. What am I going to do now? So he comes, and he gets ready for war. He puts on his crown, puts on his body armor, now goes out. And when he gets to the fall and the fountain of Sakua, notice that the presence of the Lord becomes heavier. Notice that now God intensifies his power, because it is and the king himself that's coming after David. All this time David is in Naioth. The devil is near him, but he cannot touch him. How many of you don't understand that the devil is just steps away, but he cannot touch you? The devil is just steps away, but God has paralyzed everything that the devil has been trying to do. to fulfill, hallelujah, my destiny upon. What God is saying in this hour is that you know where to run to. You know what God has been trying to do in your life. And I come to tell you it is not time to give up. It is not time for you to lay out and lay down and die. It is not time for you to say, I surrender to the plans that the enemy has for me. No. It is time for you to run. You know where to run.